Let's return to the example from lecture about my decision to landscape my yard, and let's put some numbers on it. I was thinking about doing some landscaping for $1,000, but my private benefit was only $800. Since my neighbor likes looking at nice landscaping, it would have also given him a benefit of $300. The total social benefit, including the benefit to both my neighbor and me, is greater than the total social cost. So ideally, the landscaping would get done. But if it's just up to me, I won't pay for it, because the private benefit to me is less than the private cost to me. I don't take into account the positive externality, so I don't landscape my yard. When you're hearing this example, did you ask yourself, why can't those guys just work out a deal? After all, if the better landscaping is worth $300 to my neighbor, he could just pay me $300, right? If he pays me the $300, then now the marginal benefit to me is the $800 of enjoyment I get plus the $300 from him. This is a total marginal benefit to me of $1,100, which is greater than my marginal cost of $1,000. So I would go ahead and do the landscaping. Problem solved. And the government doesn't need to get involved at all. Indeed, there's a large field of economics that discusses the way that private markets might solve externalities. But these private market solutions run into some problems in practice. First, it's easy enough in our example with only two people involved. It gets much harder when you're talking about thousands of people, each getting benefits or incurring costs. So consider using this approach to addressing air pollution from power plants. Power plants in the US that produce electricity from coal put pollutants into the atmosphere that significantly worsen air quality and harm health. Thousands of folks in the area might be affected, and a number of studies showed the health consequences are significant, causing, for example, higher rates of illness among those exposed to the pollutants. Maybe the private benefit to the power plant owner is high enough for her to build the power plant. But if she takes into account the externalities she imposes on the thousands of nearby neighbors, she wouldn't build the plant. But the problem is, how do we get the neighbors to make the plant owner account for the externality? We could have the plant owner pay all those neighbors, but it's hard to organize payment to thousands of folks. And some people might be really affected by the pollution, while others are barely affected at all. How would the plant owner know how much to pay each person, and if each person is telling the truth about the costs? So that's not very workable in reality. Another problem with private solutions to externalities is the question of who should have to pay in the first place. Suppose my neighbors are throwing a loud party. This is causing me $100 of pain because I want to get to sleep and I can't. Now, I could walk over and offer them $100 to lower the volume. But shouldn't they really pay me $100 to allow them to be loud? After all, they are imposing a negative externality on me. Shouldn't they pay? But maybe the neighbors think I'm just a lame old guy who's oversensitive. Maybe their party actually isn't that bad, but I just hate people having fun near me. If that's true, why should me being so sensitive mean that the partiers have to pay? Finally, there's the problem of social norms. It'd be sort of weird for my neighbor to offer to pay me to landscape my yard. Just think about how awkward it would be for him to offer me money to do something to my own property. Can you really imagine people doing that? Likewise, it'd be sort of weird for me to offer money to my neighbors to make a party quieter, or even weirder for them to offer me money to allow them to be loud. So I might instead just call the cops, or my neighbors might not have the party. This is a market failure. The private solution failed, so the party didn't happen. This happens a decent amount in economics. We have a pretty simple solution to a problem, but people just think it's too weird to do it in practice. It's just too different from the way that folks really think they should behave. It's for this reason that economists typically think that private solutions to externalities won't work. We can't count on power plants paying people or people paying their neighbors. Instead, we have government regulations and tax or subsidies that address these externalities.